I'm very pleased to present you today the CEWASTE project, which is a Horizon 2020 project. My name is Fanny Ratto. I'm working for ECOS, the Environmental Coalition and Standards. So CEWASTE is a 2.5 year European project that started in 2018 and ended up in 2021. It consisted of 9 project partners and with 8 linked third parties. So its ambition was to develop a voluntary certification scheme for waste treatment. So specifically, the project created, validated and launched the scheme for collection, transport and treatment facilities for key types of waste that included significant amounts of critical raw materials, for example, waste electrical and electronic equipment, commonly called WE, and batteries. So you can find here a list of 6 key objectives. So we aimed at understanding what are the existing recovery practices, standards and verification schemes, leverage the existing normative requirements to develop technical sustainability and traceability requirements, develop an insurance system, validate a new voluntary scheme through pilots, ensure the long-term sustainability of the scheme, so reflecting on the needs and what would be the roadmap for such a scheme in the long term, and ensure a transparent stakeholder process throughout this, the project. At ECOS, we were involved in the different steps of the project, and as well as this, in the final event of the, that was a conference held in March last year. So the CEWASTE key results were, first, a selected key critical raw materials or CRM equipment and key critical raw material components identified. Then we aimed at mapping current normative and legal requirements. So we analyzed more than 60 relevant normative frameworks, and we came up with a set of relevant normative requirements that were relevant for the project. The key result 3 was the development of new normative requirements. So that is to say, a new set of technical requirements for these 4 components: batteries, magnets, fluorescent powders, and PCBs. So we have also developed traceability requirements upstream and sustainability requirements for different operators, so collection points, collection facilities, logistic operators, pre-treatment and final treatment facilities in the value chain. Also developed, as mentioned before, a related assurance and verification scheme to ensure the conformity of the facilities with the CEWASTE requirements. And the assurance system was developed on 3 levels. So the scheme rules, they say the framework of the for the functioning of the certification scheme, the scheme processes, so the rules, templates and guidance, and the scheme assessment, so the rules, templates and guidance for supporting the review of audit results and decisions and certification. So based on these assurance and verification schemes, CEWASTE validated them via pilot audits. So 20 pilot audits were conducted between March and December, with all this done at collection, logistic, pre-treatment and final treatment facilities in different countries throughout the world. So Belgium, Colombia, Italy, Portugal, Rwanda, Spain, Switzerland and Turkey. So it was both in the form of physical and virtual audits, of course, linked to the COVID-19 crisis. It was also not possible to do all audits physically, but some were done still on site. And we recorded more than 60 comments following the audits and addressed them in the normative requirements. So today, CEWASTE is an integrated set of recommendations, so legislation. Let's say legal obligation to recover critical raw materials, what would be mandatory recycled content, creates economic incentives. What would be the implementation? So creation of a market for critical raw materials, so to improve the critical infrastructure technologies, these new collection models, grouping of CRM-rich products. So monitoring reporting, how to include such information in digital product passport. And enforcement, so let's say how to set standards, mandatory standards for e-waste treatment, how to enforce these European rules to counter illegal waste exports of key streams from the EU. So here you can see that there is an interesting link with Circthread through this digital product passport recommendation. For CEWASTE key result 7, so we developed a roadmap for the sustainability of the CEWASTE scheme. So you can see here the different steps that we developed for the roadmap. So the first one is we recommended to make Selenex standards mandatory. So these WE standard series that are relevant for this key waste streams and KCEs. So the second one was to make CEWASTE standards mandatory also as part of Senelec. The third one was to call for action for member states to increase the collection of CRM-rich materials. The first one was creating market pool, they say set up minimum amount of recycled materials to promote the use of recovered material. And then to facilitate the creation of demand for recycled components and materials. Also, we recommended a push for more policies and investment to ensure this economic viability of the processes, including for recyclers. And last but not least, we had also recommended a push for research and development of technologies for better and more efficient processes. So what are the potential interesting learnings for Circthread from the CEWASTE project? So first, the normative requirements. So we have developed this set of normative requirements for improving recycling of critical raw materials and the valuable materials from WE and waste batteries. As mentioned before, there's also this inclusion of information in digital product passport in CEWASTE set of recommendations. So this roadmap for the long-term sustainability of the CEWASTE scheme that is also very important in the CEWASTE scheme and relevant for the Circthread project. All the pilot ODT processing could also be interesting in terms of how the pilot project would be developed for Circthread. And of course, last but not least, all the interaction with stakeholders is all mapping related to the recycling of the valuable critical raw materials from the WE and batteries and this clustering to develop the CEWASTE network. So you can see here the project leaders, so Dr. Shahrazad Manoucheri and Dr. Sonia Valdivia, who led our nice collaboration on the Circthread project, on the CEWASTE project. So here are the CEWASTE partners. So you can see that it was a collaboration throughout Europe and you can find further information on the project website. Please don't hesitate as well to send any questions you may have on the info@cewaste.eu. And I thank you very much for your attention and I will be pleased to answer any questions as a follow-up if you have any. Thank you very much.